So we are doing lab of NAT and NAT creating IP tables. So basically we need two Ubuntu's. One of my Ubuntu is gonna be this one. So I rename that one, for example, as a Linux one. So I also mentioned that how you can create a second Ubuntu. So you can go to the file that you have, wherever it is. For example, my file is located probably, this one is here. I can copy this file and then create a second folder here. So that file is like a 7-zip file. 1, 2, 2, and then paste here that file, and then I can extract this 7-zip file. Extract it here. So I turn on the Linux one. If you look at the diagram, only Linux one has the one network interface. So I turn on this one. And then I'm gonna open the second Linux. So the second Linux is here. I rename that one as Linux 2. If you look at the diagram, Linux 2 has two network interfaces, ETH1 and ETH2. So you can go under Edit Virtual Machine. You see that one network interface is connected to the internet. That's okay. I'm gonna add another network interface. So this is a second network interface. And I put this one as a custom VNet, for example, 19. Also put the Linux one as custom VNet 19. So that means that these two Linux now are connected to together. So I turn on also Linux 2. So if you log in, just show you something. If you log into Ubuntu 1, Linux 1, you should set the IP address here. So you go here, wire settings. So the IP address that you should set for this one is, should be 192.168.1.10/24. Gateway should be, for example, you can put the gateway as 192.168.1.1. Okay. And also, I can turn off this one, turn on. Look, now I make sure that IP has been set here. So then I'm gonna go to Linux 2. Under Linux 2, one of the interfaces, here I have two interfaces. One of the interfaces is connected to NAT, which is good, is connected to internet. This one is my internet connection, so I can change the identity. For example, this is my internet connection. So because I received the IP address from NAT. So the second one, you see that I don't have an IP address here. This one should be 192.168.1.1 and /24. There isn't any gateway here. We don't have a gateway, but that's like your local network. So we have two networks here. So I'm gonna turn on this network interface and make sure that IP has been set here. Look, 192.168.1.1. Okay, from network perspective, everything is ready. Then I can do the lab. So to show you, look, now before doing this lab, if I do ping 4224, I don't have any ping. So that means that this Linux one is not connected to the internet. And the goal of this lab, connect this Linux one to the internet. So the first step that we are doing on Linux 2, first of all, because Linux 2 has an internet, check that you have an internet. Look, I have an internet. And let me make this one bigger and bigger. Okay, then you can see better. So then I'm gonna set IP forwarding in the cable, in the kernel. So it is like this, echo one. So by default is zero, but I'm setting as one. And then proc system, then net, and then IPv4, and IP underline forward. You see that I set down. So that's the first command that you're doing as enabling IP forwarding. So the second command that we are doing, so you're doing, let me clear my screen, IP tables, and then you're doing table NAT dash dash append, and we are on the post routing. So here you should enter in, like you should tell which interface is your out interface. But to know that which interface is your out interface, I'm gonna open new tab here, do if config. So look, this interface ENS33 is the internet one, and this one ENS38 is my local. Okay, so here when you're typing out interface should be your should be your internet interface. So my internet interface is here, is ENS33. So I put here ENS33. Okay, and then dash J, sorry, dash J, and then masquerade. Masquerade, it is like a NAT, like you're hiding some IP address behind the public IP address. We call that one masquerade. Actually, I missed one, E-rate. So then under IP tables, and then dash dash append forward. Now we should introduce the local interface. Dash dash in dash interface, and then which interface was local? So if you look at here, ENS38 was local. So you put here ENS38 dash J accept. So what I'm saying, now, okay, from local to that outside, ENS38 to ENS33, packets should be accepted. So if you come back to Linux 1, and do a ping now. Look, now we have a ping. That means that now Linux 2 is as a router. If you come back here and type IP tables dash L, also you can put the line numbers as well. You see that I put here one policy and it's saying that accept all, anywhere, any destination. So if you want to work with the look under IP the tables, we have three policies: input, forward, and output. If I have a policy under input, I can go and modify or delete that one. But now only I have a policy on the forward. So then I can write like this, IP tables dash D. So if I wanna delete any policy, so this policy is policy number one, right? So I can put here, it is on the forward, right? So first forward. And then which policy number it is? Policy number one. So look now, if I do policy like dash L, look, there isn't any policy here. So now, if you want to drop the packet from this Linux one, because Linux one is 192.168.110. So you can write this one, IP tables dash A forward. Dash S means source and 192.168. The IP address of the source is 192.168.110. And dash J drop. So that means that drop that packet. So look now, if you come back here and do the ping, ping doesn't work. That means that you're dropping the packets. And that's it from this lab.